We have breaking news tonight out of Seaside. New information on a Central Coast murder investigation that's nearly 41 years old. Tonight, Seaside detectives are telling Action News they believe they have cracked that murder case that dates back to 1969. The man who is being charged was found all the way in Texas. Police say they found James Terry Mason in Cedar Hill, Texas. It is a suburb of Dallas. He has been arrested in connection with the 1969 murder of then 19-year-old Chris Lopes from Seaside. Action News reporter Stephanie Truong has the story. She's live in Saline in Seaside.
Dan Lopes was a popular guy in town, the captain of the Seaside High School varsity basketball team. A lot of people knew him. Killed at a party again in 1969, and that case quickly went cold. We spoke with his sister tonight, who says she feels good about it. She never gave up, and neither did this man here. We have Seaside Detective Nick Borges with us. Thanks so much for talking to us. Detective, you learned about this 3 years ago. Tell us about how you found about the case.
I made an arrest of a gentleman for some minor charges, and in casual conversation, he brought this case up and said that that was an unsolved murder here in Seaside.
Okay, and so you quickly looked into the case, looking at old newspaper archives. Tell us about what you had to do then.
I had to research and locate the case, being that it was so old, it wasn't in our current databases. And I was able to do that through our investigations bureau at the time when I was a patrol officer, and found that this case did exist and it was unsolved.
Okay. Now, you finally got a breakthrough with some support from other detectives this year. You also got an eyewitness who came forward. Tell us about that.
Yes, the cold case project that we've been involved with for some time came forward and involved the district attorney's office, local agencies, Monterey, Pacific Grove, Marina, and through that, the resources came together. And an eyewitness emerged and really jump-started this case.
Okay, and lastly, you must feel good. You were able to go to Texas. You saw the man who you believe was responsible for this murder. Tell me how you feel after sticking with it for 3 years.
Well, I think most importantly, it's how the family feels. They are so happy this happened. They were hysterical when I broke the news, and that's truly what this is all about. And we hope that anyone else that was at this party that was there would come forward and provide that.
Thank you, Detective, so much for speaking with us. So again, 40 years later, we've got this possible suspect in this murder. Again, he will have his day in court, but detectives believe and are very confident that they've got the right man. Dan, back to you.
All right, thank you, Stephanie. And we're continuing to follow this case. We will have much more detail on this murder investigation and how police managed to pull it together after more than four decades, all coming up tonight on Action News at 10 and 11.